T-minus 20 seconds. T-minus 15. Vehicle is on.
T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7.
The thing that I'm most excited about tonight is seeing this rocket launch. We've had one attempt to put a satellite in space, and the result was a large crater in former Soviet bloc country.
Approximately 125 students from Montana State University have worked on the Explorer 1 Prime satellite project.
This time, we hope to put a satellite in space, and then tomorrow we get to hear it.
Explorer is one of only three university-built satellites that were chosen to fly on NASA's Glory mission.
6, 5, 4.
Over the years, we've had a number of setbacks with some of our other small satellite projects, and so this particular evening has special significance, I guess, because it will be our first opportunity to actually have one of our own spacecraft in orbit.
Explorer 1 Prime was built to honor the first successful U.S. satellite and James Van Allen. Van Allen was the professor and mentor to Montana State University professor David Klumpar.
The key thing is when the satellite goes overhead, I hope we receive a signal. So I don't think I'll stop stressing until that happens.
The Glory mission is designed to measure the sun's energy output and distribution of airborne aerosol particles in the upper atmosphere.
I hope it launches.
3, 2, 1, 0, and ignition of the Taurus rocket. With Glory, monitoring how changes in Earth climate may affect our lives.
Stage 0 TVA nominal. The Stage 0 TVA system is operating as expected to maintain vehicle attitude. Vehicle velocity is approximately 2,000 miles per hour at an altitude of approximately 10 miles. Stage 0 burnout.
This is Taurus Launch Control. We're 15 minutes, 35 seconds since the liftoff of the Taurus XL rocket. The flight was going well until the time of fairing separation, and then we had data coming into the Mission Director Center from our Vandenberg tracking station and from Point Magoo that we did not have a successful fairing separation from the Taurus, and there was insufficient velocity with the fairing still on for the vehicle to be able to achieve orbit.
The fairing didn't separate, now we're in a very low geosynchronous orbit underneath the water. Pretty depressed, but it's the way things go, I guess. Third time's the charm.
MSU built a twin satellite that is scheduled to launch on October 25th on another NASA mission.
We couldn't do anything about it. We've been out of control for the last 4 months,
yeah.
So we're just waiting for something to go right.
Yeah.
And it's out of our hands, so
what are you gonna do?